everybody, and today we're talking about periodic waveforms. And periodic waveforms are simply waveforms that repeat, and we'll be using them a lot. We'll be looking at the voltage and the current waveforms, and ultimately at power. But first we're just going to start with simple waveforms. And I've drawn a few periodic waveforms here. The very simple one is a sinusoid. People are very commonly know that waveform. And I've drawn a few other ones. This is a type of pulsed waveform. It can have positive and negative. And you can also have waveforms that are all positive or triangular in shape like this. The waveform isn't important. What's important is that it repeats. So from 0 to t, t is your period. You have the first period. And then the second, third, fourth, and so on, you're going to have the exact same pattern. We're going to talk about two very important values for these periodic waveforms. And one is the average, and the second one is the RMS value, or the root mean square value. Okay, so the average one is more intuitive. So let's look at these examples real quick. And for this sinusoidal waveform, what's the average value? What's the average value, Valerie? Correct. For this one, it would be zero. So here, if you take the average here, it's zero, right? And what about this waveform? Probably close to zero, because we have some positive and some negative. So the average value would be somewhere around zero. And what about for this one? Valerie says something slightly positive. So somewhere in the middle here, you'd have an average value. Okay, that's a very simple calculation for the average. So let's write that value out. For this class, we'll be using the notation of square brackets to mean the average value. V is actually V of t, so it's actually going to be this waveform. We're going to use voltage. You could also use current. And the average is simply going to be the average value, also the mean value. So you're looking over one period here, and then you're going to take an integral from 0 to t, which is the time of the period, and you're simply going to take your value, V of t, and dt here. So you finish your integral, and you divide by the time. So that's your average or mean value for your waveform. The second one is the root mean square. And first we're just going to define it. The name actually defines it. So it's the root of the mean of the square of a waveform. So let's start with the root part, the square root. Then we're going to take the mean. Mean and average are the same. Oh, and we're going to define this as a capital letter V for voltage. Okay, so now we take the mean, 1 over t. Integrate from 0 to t. And we're going to put something inside here. First, I'm going to close the integral here. And we're going to do the square of our value. So here we're going to do V of t. And that quantity will be squared. So this is the definition of the root mean square value, the RMS value, for a waveform. If we go back and look at these waveforms, essentially what you're doing is you're going to square them, so all the negatives will become positive. And then you're going to take the average of that and then take the square root of it. So the RMS value of this waveform will not be zero. The average is zero, but the RMS value will be positive. Same for this one, it will be a little positive, and same for this as well. You can think of the root mean square value as the equivalent voltage for if you put this waveform, or your waveform of choice, over a resistor. So I'm going to write this out in equation form. So this is the relationship between these two. So you can think about power to a system over a resistor would be the voltage waveform squared over the resistor. And if we were to take the average of these, we would get an average power out. And the root mean square is essentially the equivalent voltage squared here over the same resistor. So if our resistor is constant, so you can actually take that out of the average, so these would be able to cancel. And what you'd be left with is the average of V squared equals the RMS value squared. So there's an important relationship. This is always true. The v squared here, so this is the time domain value squared, is equal to, average of the square is equal to the RMS value squared. This is true, a true relationship. Some students make this mistake. They will try to make these things equivalent. This is not true, not true, not true, not true. So this relationship is true based on the definition of the RMS value in relation to the average, and this is not true. So do not try to make this relationship here. We talked about periodic waveforms, which are simply waveforms that repeat over multiple periods, and we gave some examples, and we defined the average or mean value using this equation, and the root mean square or RMS value using this equation. We talked about some relationships. If this isn't quite clear to you yet, don't worry. This is a statement you can rely on. This one actually is only true for DC values, but generally not true. And if you get confused, always go back to the original equation, and it will help you understand the waveform.